right, we've got Eric Mann on here now. 14 tournament tonight, Eric. Not a very good start last night.
No, very disappointing for us, especially seeing as we're defending champions. Nigel Crabtree didn't do very well as per usual last night. You know what he's like. Anyway, on a more serious note, a bit disappointing.
Results haven't gone your way just last couple of weeks. I know it was a brilliant match here last week, but the points went to Long Eaton.
Yeah, that's just what we don't want. But it's early days. We're like a month behind, really, everybody else, I feel, at the moment. So hopefully by the time the league comes round, everybody will be clicking and things will be a little bit happier and rosier.
The signs have been that if the team can all pull together, they've got just one of the best sides in the league. There's no doubt about that, but just they don't seem to be all clicking together at the same time at the moment.
Yeah, at the moment, I don't know if you noticed last week, we're lacking a little bit of confidence here in home track. Now, Dave Tatum and Dave Pemberton during the week have done a lot of work on the track and it looks a lot better tonight, although it does look a bit slick, which doesn't suit myself and probably one or two others. But at least it's going to be smooth and we can, take steps from there.
Yeah, so the time the league comes round, then things should be in a better position, you feel?
Yeah, as I say, the track wasn't to our liking. This is where you need to build your confidence up. And, you know, away from home, we've been doing really well. We've been getting some good scores. So if we build the confidence up here, we should be able to go and lick them away from home.
Best luck for tonight then, Eric Monaghan. Thank you very much.
Cheers.
We've now got Jan Steckman here, riding for Long Eaton, of course, tonight. Super victory here last week, Jan.
Yeah, it was good. It was a close finish, and I'm sure the fans enjoyed it.
Must have been great for the lads to pull back a revenge win from the defeat a couple of weeks before that.
Definitely, yeah. We've been struggling with some problems all through the team, so it was nice to get another away win. We all pulled together well, and it worked out in the end.
Yeah, the team seems to be very well balanced now at the moment. Seems to be got off the ground well after the early start of the season.
Yeah, like I said, you know, we've all had our little problems, but you know, slowly we're all getting sorted out, and hopefully we should be on top gear, all of us.
Yeah, obviously with the win last week, you must be very confident of a good result tonight.
Yeah, well, we had actually our problems yesterday, you know, but we still got second, so I only scored a point and had an ND failure and whatnot. The track looks a bit slick, but we should be okay.
How was the feeling at Long Eaton this year about going into the first division? The management looking for that sort of thing?
I think it's too early to tell, you know. We got a good, solid side and we all get on well, and hopefully we can, you know, finish in the top half, maybe even look for something, you know, a trophy along the way, but whether we're going to win the league or not, you know, it's way too early to tell.
Thanks very much, Jan Steckman. Thank you.
Thanks.
I've got Stephen Davis here riding at Stoke tonight for Peterborough. Good result for the Panthers last night, Steve.
Yeah, it's it was a good result. We've been going pretty good at Peterborough. The team's all going good at the moment, so hopefully we're going to, you know, be up there, you know, again tonight.
Yeah, you seem to have a little bit of a shaky start just at the start of the season, but things have picked up well over the last couple of weeks or so.
Yeah, we've been pretty consistent at home, you know, and also that good win at Rye House. You know, we've been going pretty good, but tonight will be another night, and we'll just have to see what we can do.
There seems to be a lot of fresh faces in all the teams of the second division this year, but some very strong sides and some very 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 close results this season.
Yeah, it's opened it up a lot, bringing foreigners into the division two, which is good. You know, it's made it more competitive, and I think it's brought the standard of racing up a bit.
Yeah, and how do you feel at Peter about the thoughts of moving into the first division? Are they keen on it?
Yeah, I think so, yeah. Because they've got quite a few riders out. They own a lot of riders now. You know, they've got the likes of Mick Poole and Craig Hodgson. You know, if they did go back in Division 1, you know, that they can be recalled, and you know, I think it could be good.
How do you feel you're going to go tonight? Have you rode at Stoke before?
No, I haven't rode here before, but, it looks a good little track anyway, good racing little track.
Yeah, so best of luck tonight anyway, Stephen Davis. Thanks very much. Thank you. Stoke Potters are the current 14 tournament champions, but on present form with a very poor run of results, their chances of retaining the trophy look slight indeed. Tonight is the second leg, with Peterborough coming out on top last night on their home circuit. Coming into heat number one, in red for the Potters we have Eric Monahan, in blue for the Milton Keynes Knights that's Troy Butler, in white Rob Tilbury for Long Eaton, and in yellow and black for the Panthers Stephen Davis. Your riders for heat number one.
Attention, Mazzy, and this is heat one in the second heat of the 14 tournament. Eric Monahan, Troy Butler, Rob Tilbury, and Steve Davis. That's the way it looks.
Well, the cheers go up in the cracker of a start by Stokes' Eric Monahan, the rider in red, Rob Tilbury following from Long Eaton. Well, Rob Tilbury and Stephen Davis coming to blows then, the pits bend, and Stephen Davis driving under. Rob Tilbury now fighting it out with Troy Butler. Troy Butler at the back at the moment, currently top of the averages in the second division with over 10 points, but struggling here in heat number one. Peter, of course, coming out on top of the pile last night with 37 points. Long Eaton second with 24. Milton Keynes with 19 and Stoke with 16. So the Potters with all the work to do. But Eric Monahan setting the pace here in heat number one. Well, there it is, hand in the air. 3 points to Eric Monahan. 2 points to Stephen Davis of Peterborough. And 1 point to Rob Tilbury of Long Eaton. That's your result for heat number one.
Including.
So, good start for the Potters in heat number one as Eric Monahan recorded a time of 63.4 seconds. Going to heat number two in red, there we are, just warming up. That's Nigel Crabtree, currently third in the averages in the second division at the moment. In blue will be the very popular Gordon Kerrett, riding this year for Milton Keynes. In white, Mark Blackbird, here last week for that famous victory over the Potters for Long Eaton. Score of 5 points on the night. And in yellow and black, Michael Blixt. The riders for heat number two. Well,
looks like the rider in yellow and black, Mr. Blix, there, touching the tapes, and the red light goes on. So, I'll be the rider in yellow and black, excluded for tape touching.
All right then, we're underway again. Mark Linden coming in, of course, replacing Michael Blix.
Well, there we are, the voice of George Andrews tells the story. And Mark Linden brought in to replace Michael Blix. So it's Nigel Crabtree, Gordon Kennett, Mark Blackbird and Mark Linden, heat number two. Well, flyer from the outside, Long Eaton's Mark Blackbird's away. Gordon Kennett and Nigel Crabtree took it into battle it out for second place, but Gordon Kennett throw it into the pits bend. Nigel Crabtree locking back and nearly clashing with Mark Linden, but a good race here by Mark Blackbird powering away, looking for 3 points for the Invaders. Gordon Kennett, of course, very seasoned campaigner with so many seasons for the Eastbourne Eagles, but obviously moving on to Milton Keynes with the shutting of Eastbourne. Excellent pictures there of Mark Blackbird and Gordon Kennett with Nigel Crabtree taking up third place. One final corner for Mark Blackbird, quick glance over his shoulder and Gordon Kennett trying to come through the inside, but that's a win for Mark Blackbird, 3 points to him, 2 points to Gordon Kennett and 1 point to Nigel Crabtree. That's aggressive scores now, Stoke 4, Long Eaton 4, Milton Keynes 2 and Peterborough 2. Heat number 2. So the Potters and the Invaders sharing the lead at the moment, 4 points each as we go into heat number 3. In red this time for the Potters will be Gary Chesil, there he is. In blue will be Peter Glantz, in yellow Jan Steckman. White rather, Jan Steckman, and in yellow and black, Rickard Helsane. Jan Steckman, of course, here last week, the Long Eaton Invaders, and won them the points. That dramatic last heat run over Chris Cobby. Some say it was very controversial indeed, but here we are now, heat number 3. Gary Chesil, Peter Gladys, Jan Steckman, Rickard Helsane. Well, outside grid sharp again, Rickard Helsane doing the business, but now dropping back, riding white, Jan Steckman going through with Peter Glantz following. Peter Glantz now driving wide and Mr. Helsane coming through, but the ultra smooth style of Jan Steckman going away, looking for the second heat win for the Invaders of the night. Jan, a former British League Division 1 rider with Wolverhampton. And really enjoying his race in the Sunbike League Division 2 this year. Second at the moment in yellow, that's Rickard Helsane, formerly with Long Eaton, and now you could say coming towards the end of his career. Very seasoned campaigner indeed. We are to the chequered flag. That's 3 points to Jan Steckman, 2 points to Rickard Helsane, and 1 to Peter Glantz. 4 now to Stoke, 7 to Long Eaton, 3 to Milton Keynes, and 4 to the Panthers. Heat number 3. We're into heat number 4 with the Invaders just holding out a lead with the 7 points. Rider in red will be for the Potters, Chris Cobby. In blue, replacing Paul Woods, that's Nigel Diaf. In white for the Invaders, Carl Blackbird. And in yellow and black, Scott Norman. Your riders for heat number 4, here we go. Good start by the rider in blue, that's Nigel Diaf. Recovering this year after a poor season with the Invaders last year and so many problems with injuries, but going well here. Chris Cobby took it into second place, riding red. And Carl Blackbird battling out here with Chris Cobby for second place. Scott Norman trail at the moment for the Panthers. But good ride here by Nigel Diaf. Chris Cobby just about holding on to second place, closely followed by Carl Blackbird of the Invaders. Chris Cobby, score of 8 points here last week against the Invaders, but it was all in vain, I'm afraid. There we are, coming around the last corner. That's 3 points to Nigel Deer, 2 points to Chris Cobby, 1 point to Carl Blackbird. And progressive scores after heat four. Potters 6, Invaders 8, Knights 6 and the Panthers 4 after heat number 4.
And don't forget as well, if you're looking for any beverage, the bar behind, on the main straight, or the home straight, and of course adjacent to that, just to the right or left.
So the Invaders maintain their lead with 8 points after four races, six to the Potters, six to the Knights and four to the Panthers. Going to heat number 5 in blue there. That's Gordon Kennett, tried to snatch a win in the second heat, but held out by Mark Blackbird. In red will be Bootsy Monahan, winner of heat number 1. In white, Jan Steckman, also previous winner. And in yellow and black, second ride out for Scott Norman. Heat number 5. Eric Monahan. Well, the rider in white from the inside line, that's Jan Steckman powering away and really has opened up a good lead here down the back straight. Scott Norman in second place, but Eric Monahan taking the outside line, but Gordon Kennett now coming through. Bootsy having to really bust the gut here to try and gain any advantage and drawing alongside Gordon Kennett. Good scrap for the minor placing. Gordon Kennett now moving underneath the rider in yellow. That's Scott Norman. Super race here. Really is a hell of a dog scrap for second place, you could say. But Jan Steckman loops over his shoulder. He's well away, but race for second place really heating up now. Scott Norman just about holding on in front of Knight's Gordon Kennett and Bootsy Monahan now dropping back. That's a good win for Jan Steckman. Second place going to Scott Norman and third place going to Knight's Gordon Kennett. That's 6 points now to Stoke, 11 to Long Eaton, 7 to Milton Keynes and 6 to the Panthers after 5 heats.
Pictures, you name it, the lads have got it. If it's there, you can have it. If it isn't, just pour it out and they'll give you an opportunity to order those.
Heat number 6 brings out Stoke captain Nigel Crabtree with the third place in his first ride. In blue will be Troy Butler, in yellow there, that's Rickard Elsane. And in white will be for the Invaders, Carl Blackbird. Your riders for heat number 6. Well, Nigel Crabtree missing the gate, but no problems for Carl Blackbird. He's away. And Troy Butler moving into second position. As I mentioned earlier on, Troy Butler currently top of the averages with over 10 points, but a very poor first ride, making up for it now, chasing Carl Blackbird. Nigel Crabtree is one has got to say, looks rather underpowered tonight, struggling at the moment. Eric Monahan was talking earlier on about track conditions not suiting the Potters and certainly things not suiting them again this evening. So Carl Blackbird doing the business here for the Invaders, currently in the lead with 11 points. 3 more points look as though they're coming their way here. Here we are, it's a good win for Carl Blackbird, 3 points to him, 2 points to Troy Butler and 1 to Nigel Crabtree. That's 7 points now to Stoke, 14 to Long Eaton, 9 to the Knights and 6 to the Panthers after 6 heats. So the Invaders came here and snatched a win over the Potters, 46-44, showing a liking for the track and showing a liking for the track once again tonight. Rob Tilbury represents the Invaders here in heat number 7. In red will be Gary Chesel. In blue, replacing Paul Woods, that's Nigel Diath. Good win for Nigel, first time out. And in yellow and black, Mike Elblix. There we go. And once again, well, good start for Rob Tilbury, and Gary Chesel took into second place. Gary with some rather poor form over the last few weeks after an excellent start for the Potters in the 91 season. It's a head down for former Arena Essex Hammers rider, that's Rob Tilbury, representing the Invaders this evening. Gary Chesel going wide and well, letting Nigel Diath through now. Rob Tilbury, the late start of the season, really has settled down nicely over the last few weeks and doing the business here once again this evening. Looking for 3 points for the Invaders in heat number 7 to take their score even further in front. And to the chequered flag, that's 3 points to Rob Tilbury, 2 to Nigel Diath and 1 to Gary Chesel. Progressive scores, Stoke 8, Long Eaton now 17, Milton Keynes 11 and Peterborough 6 points. Going to heat number 8, things looking very serious indeed for the Potters if they're to gain enough points to qualify for the next round, or the finals, I should say, the 14 tournament. Struggling last night, finishing with just 16 points, and presently just with 8 points tonight. Going to heat number 8, in red, Chris Cobby, in blue, Peter Glantz, white, Matt Blackbird, yellow and black, Stephen Davis. Potters has very little success the last few weeks. Chris Cobby making a good start, but Peter Glantz now drawing level and going past. Peter Glantz, one of the Milton Keynes Knights this season, in much better form, a rather different looking side altogether. Powerful looking side indeed. Well, there's a rider in yellow going through on Mark Blackbird. Ruthless riding indeed by Stephen Davis. Stephen boring his way through Chris Cobby and Mark Blackbird. Ruthless stuff indeed, but coming through into second place. Spoke to Stephen earlier on about Peterborough's chances this season. Very optimistic indeed. So coming to the line, that's 3 points to Peter Glantz, 2 points to Stephen Davis, and 1 to Mark Blackbird. And there we are, scores after heat 8. Into heat number 9. Rider in yellow there, that's Michael Blixt. In red will be Bootsy Monaghan. Good start for Eric tonight, but not too good last time out. In blue will be Peter Glantz and in white, Carl Blackbird. Riders for heat number 9. Tapes are up and away they go, and well, slide into first turn and find himself on his rear at the moment. That's Peter Glantz. Track staff going to his aid as he's jammed underneath the bike. Looks as though he's okay at first sight.
Start there, let's hope there's no problems. Carl Blackbird and Michael.
So nice to see Peter Glantz back at his feet, returning to takes the rerun of heat number 9. Peter Glantz, Eric Monaghan, Carl Blackbird, and from the outside, grid 4, that's Mike Elblix, rerun of heat number 9. riders taking a little bit of time to settle down as our starter gets them into line, and here we go. Second time of asking, and good start from the outside, boring round. That's Michael Blixt going past Peter Glantz. Well, some ruthless riding there by the riding white. That's Carl Blackford, boring underneath Eric Monaghan, taking up third place. Really do need to start turning on the power now if they're to gain enough points to stand any chance of reaching the finals. Michael Blixt, super ride here after two nil scores so far, looking for 3 points here in his third outing. Eric Monon trying to come through on Peter Glantz, but Peter blocking him out. That's a good win for Michael Blixt. 3 points to him, 2 points to Carl Blackbird, and one to Peter Glantz. That's 8 points now to the Potters, 20 to the Invaders, 15 to the Knights, and 11 to the Panthers after heat number 9. Number 10, and there's Nigel Crabtree. 15-point maximum here last week against the Invaders, but no maximum for Nigel tonight. Currently with just 2 points from two rides. In yellow there, that is Stephen Davis. Ruthless ride last time out for Stephen to gain 2 points. In white will be the very classy Jan Steckman. And in blue, good rides tonight for Nigel Diaz. Heat number 10. Well, super night so far for Nigel Diaz, and from the tapes, there he goes. Jan Steckman into second, and Stephen Davis in third. And Nigel Crabtree, well, very unusual sight here, struggling indeed. Two third places, and now find himself at the rear of the field in heat number 10. Nigel Diaz with his second term for the Knights, as I said before last year, representing Long Eaton, but suffered a very bad foot injury at Eastbourne. One lap to go for Nigel Diaz, looking for his second heat win of the evening. 5 points so far for Nigel, this could take him on to 8 points. Very good total indeed so far. There it is, 3 points to Nigel Diaz, 2 points to Jan Steckman, and 1 point to Stephen Davis. That's 8 points to the Potters so far, 22 to Longine, 18 to the Knights, and 12 to the Panthers after heat number 10. Disaster for the Potters in the last three heats. Makes things look very, very difficult indeed. Just with 8 points. Long Eaton well out in front with 22 points, and excellent form by their four riders this evening. Heat number 11. There's Gary Chesil. Really could do with a good race here to bring the Potters fans back to life. In blue, coming to the tapes, that's Troy Butler, former British League Division 1 rider with the Oxford. In white will be Mark Blackbird, and in yellow and black, Scott Norman. Heat number 11. Into the first turn, rider in blue, that's Troy Butler. 2 points so far this evening, he's away. And second place, Mark Blackbird, Scott Norman and Gary Chesil for the minor point. Well, disaster once again for the Potters. Gary Chesil really struggling here. Just 1 point tonight so far. Troy Butler opening up a very good lead indeed. Slow start for Troy, but coming into form now. Blackbird, 4 points so far. Started the night off with a very classy win indeed. Racing conditions excellent indeed tonight. Weather holding out. And coming to the line, that's the rider in blue. 3 points to Troy Butler, 2 points to Mark Blackburn and one to Scott Norman. That's 8 to the Potters, 24 to the Invaders, 21 to the Knights and 13 to the Panthers after heat number 11. Tonight's meeting, of course, sponsored by Heat, H-E-A-T, that's Heat Electric Advisory Team. And Speedway, of course, always very grateful to any sponsors indeed. We're into heat number 12 in red, Chris Cobby, in blue, Gordon Kennett, in white, Rob Tilbury, and in yellow and black, Rickard Elsaid. Heat number 12. Veteran Swedes away, Rickard Elsaid in front of veteran from Milton Keynes, you could say, Gordon Kennett. He's trying to ball underneath Rickard Elsaid. Excellent race here. And B&J Video Services will remember that excellent racing last year between Gordon Kennett and Rickard Elsaid at Long Eaton. Looks to be no exception as these two riders really are turning on the power here in heat number 12. Rickard Elsaid trying to hold out Gordon Kennett. Excellent stuff indeed. Well, you could throw a handkerchief over the pair of them at the moment, nothing in it. Rider in white, that's Rob Tilbury in third place. Gordon Kennett still there going underneath Rickard Elsaid, but Rickard holding him coming to last turn. Well, there we are, Gordon Kennett coming through, and excellent win by him. 3 points to Gordon Kennett, 2 points to Rickard Elsaid, and one to Rob Tilbury. There we are, the scores after heat number 12 now. Potters 8, the Long Eaton Invaders 25, Milton Keynes Knights 24, and Peterborough Panthers 15. So, super ride by Gordon Kennett and Rickard Elsaid in heat number 12. Heat number 13 in red for the Potters, Nigel Crabtree, Peter Glantz in blue. Rob Tilbury, second ride in a run for him, in white, and in yellow and black, Scott Norman. Heat number 13. Well, better start this time for Nigel Crabtree, usually a very fast starter indeed. He's away in heat number 13 to the delight of the Potters fans. Potters with no fewer than five blank scores over the last five heats. Nigel Crabtree trying to correct that now. Rob Tilbury in second place and Scott Norman in third. Nigel with just 2 points from three outings. Looks as though his total could go to 5 points for the evening. Second place, Rob Tilbury. This could give him a total of 7 points if Rob finishes the race in second place. There we are. 3 points to Nigel Crabtree, 2 points to Rob Tilbury, and 1 point to Scott Norman. That's 11 points to the Potters, 27 to the Invaders, 24 to the Knights, and 16 to the Panthers after heat number 13.
And let's not help the engine. The gremlins are boring the process.
So the meeting looks to be between Long Eaton and Milton Keynes. Invaders just 3 points in front, going to heat number 14, just three races left. In red this time, Eric Monahan. In blue there, that's Nigel Diaf. Excellent racing so far, 8 points so far for Nigel Diaf. In white, brought out, that's Kai Niemi. and in yellow and black, Rickard Elsain. Heat number 14. Well, good first start for Kainimi, but now dropping back. Reared slightly, but to Rickard Elsain, well, another good start by Mr. Elsain here. Eric Monon into second place. Eric Monon with a good start to the evening, but to two last places. Looking for a good race here to finish the night off with, but Rickard Elsain, that very, very familiar style, swinging leg and going for 3 points. Kainimi coming through on Eric Monahan. Kainimi riding reserve tonight, but going well in the two reserves races, so given a place here. Doing battle with Rickard Elsain and doing very well indeed. Finland International and a rider who's been in quite a few world finals, that's Kainimi doing the business here, putting the pressure on Rickard Elsain. Well, that's 3 points to Rickard Elsain, 2 points to Kainimi and 1 point to Eric Monahan. That's 12 points now to the Potters, 29 to the Invaders, 24 to Knights and 19 to the Panthers, heat number 14.
Here's the quickie on the raffle numbers again.
Just two heats to go and things looking very nicely for the Invaders, 29 points, but disaster completely for the Potters. They really do look out of the hunt completely, and qualifying for final does look extremely rare now, but going into heat number 15, just two heats to go in yellow, that's Stephen Davis. Some exciting riding from Stephen tonight. In red will be Gary Chesley, in white Carl Blackbird, and in blue. Good racing tonight from Gordon Kennett. Heat number 15. Takes go up into the first corner and Stephen Davis pulling back, but Carl Blackbird going through. Carl Blackbird with one previous heat win tonight, going well. Well, Gordon Kennett once again with that favourite inside line, boring through on Stephen Davis, getting a little bit of his own medicine, you could say. Gordon Kennett with also one previous heat win, 6 points from three rides. Going well in heat number 15 behind Carl Blackbird. Blackbird, of course, a former British League Division 1 rider, one-time rider for the famous Bellevue Aces. Riding for Edinburgh last season and doing well here for the Invaders tonight. Going around the last corner and, well, there we are, the sloop from Carl Blackbird. 3 points to him, 2 points to Gordon Kennett and one to Stephen Davis. After 15 heats, Stoke 12. Long Eaton 32, Milton Keynes 26 and Peterborough 20 points going into heat number 16. So the final heat of the night in tonight's HEAT 14 tournament, second leg between the Abacus Potters, the Graham Knights, Long Eaton Invaders and the Peterborough Panthers this evening.
So Dave Clark, wearing red, obviously Chris Cobbey.
Dave Clark brought out to replace the out-of-form Chris Cobbey. In blue will be Troy Butler with 5 points so far tonight. In white, Jan Steckman, just one beating for Jan tonight, 8 points from three rides. And in yellow and black, Mike Elblix, two riders for heat number 16. Takes go up and a good start by David Clark on the inside, but the rider in blue, that's Troy Butler, coming out in front into the back straight, but David Clark taking up second place here. Well, David Clark riding the reserve position for the Stoke Potter this year, former Coventry Junior, and well, very close indeed there, coming out the second turn with Jan Steckman doing well here to older Mr. Steckman, but Jan Steckman looking to come into that inside run, favourite line of his. Well, there they are entering the last lap. Just, well, there he is, Jan Stekman coming through, and, well, the Potterhead fans won't really like that move following last week's procedures. Now, one wheel coming to the line, that's 3 points to Troy Butler, 2 points to Jan Stekman, and third place going to David Clark. There we are, after 16 heats tonight of the 14 tournament. There are the final scorings. Stoke with 13 points, bottom of the pile tonight, unfortunately. Invaders finishing top of the pile with 34 points. Second place going to the Knights with 29, and the Panthers with 20 points. So, going into the third leg, Long Eaton in front with just 58 points. Peter Booth, 57. Milton Keynes on closely following on 48, and well, Stoke Luke really out of it at the moment on 29 points. We hope that you've enjoyed tonight's Speedway, a B&J Video Services production, and we'll see you once again for more Speedway. Bye for now. 63.4, a second white.